Hey guys, it's Adam from ATP Powerlifting, and today I'm going to put together the most comprehensive guide on YouTube to which combo rack you should get and why. So let's get to it. We're going to go over the most popular combo racks available right now. We're going to go Rogue Fitness, Elite FTS, ER, the Texas Strength Combo Rack, Alico, and the Bells of Strength Combo Rack. All right, so let's start off on how much each one costs. The Alico Rack is the most by far. Now, I did find something saying that it was $3,000 on the Garage Gym Reviews website, but since it wasn't listed on their website, on the Alico website, I went out and I emailed them, and they gave me an official quote at $4,602, not including shipping, and they also went to say that they do not keep the rack in a warehouse in the United States like they do for some other items, so it will have to be shipped from Sweden, which I'm sure is more money. The next one is the Elite FTS rack at just over $2,700. That does not include shipping. The Rogue rack at $2,500 does not include shipping. The ER combo rack at $2,800, so it is slightly more than the Rogue rack, but it does include shipping to most of the states in the United States. Next is the Texas Strength System rack, coming in at $1,690. This does not include the spotter arms, which you probably want, so another $265 there, and then shipping as well. And the cheapest one, coming in at just under $1,100, plus shipping from Canada, is the Bells of Steel combo rack. Something noteworthy is that if you do live in Canada, that they do offer free shipping to some parts of Canada. Now let's look at the materials that are used to create these racks. On the Rogue rack, it's going to be a 7-gauge steel. The same on the Elite. The ER rack is 7 and 11-gauge steel, so most likely the uprights are going to be 7-gauge. The Texas Strength System is going to be the same way. The Alico does not have any information on the gauge steel used to construct it, but is most likely, again, just like the ER and Texas Strength System, it's going to be 7 and 11. And then the Bells of Strength combo rack comes in at the lowest gauge steel at 12. Next, let's look at the size slash footprint of each combo rack. So this is going to be important for some of you that are trying to put this in your garage or your basement, especially your basement when they're heavy. But hopefully you're putting them together down there and not trying to carry it down the hatchway like I know some of you would. So the biggest one, on average, is going to be the Rogue. It has one of the largest footprints, and it weighs in at 505 pounds. And also the bench height is 17.5, which is the highest the IPF allows. The next one is going to be the Elite FTS. The footprint is somewhat close. I messaged them because they didn't have any information on the weight, and they told me that the weight's 800 pounds. I find that really hard to believe, that it's that much bigger and heavier, what, almost 300 pounds heavier than the Rogue rack, especially since I've used all of these racks or seen all of these racks before, and the Elite FTS does not look like it's 300 pounds heavier than the Rogue rack, considering they're both using the same gauge of steel for construction. So I'm going to go ahead and say that 800 pounds is probably with it on a skid, ready to be shipped with the cable tie downs and the box and whatever else they're using to throw on there. So it's probably an equal weight to the Rogue rack, considering it's using the same gauge steel. The next one is going to be the ER rack. It has no spec for the footprint. It's 330 pounds. And they also said that is shipping weight, so that's including the skid or the pallet and the tie downs and everything else that goes into that. That's not just the weight of the combo rack itself. Again, bench height is 17.5. Next is going to be the Texas Strength Systems combo rack. They pretty much have no specs on anything, no footprint spec, no weight spec. And their bench is also 17.5, although I've used it, and I don't know if it's from it compressing or whatever, but it seemed a little bit shorter than 17.5, but we'll give them the benefit of the doubt as it's listed as 17.5. Alico, they did give us a footprint measurement and a weight measurement, so it's 253 pounds and no bench height spec, but it's going to be somewhere between 16.5 and 17.5 as it is IPF approved. And the last one, the Bells of Steel, is definitely the smallest footprint by far. I've seen this one in person, although they've never released a spec on the footprint, and it is definitely the lightest, coming in at only 165 pounds, with a bench height of 16.5 inches, which is the lowest height you can have to be IPS approved, which they are not IPF approved, but we'll get to that later. Also, a note is that it only being 165 pounds, you're definitely gonna have to bolt this to the floor or put some type of weight on it. So the biggest cons, so starting off with the Rogue Rack, I've heard that it's harder to unrack because of the larger diameter size, and the bench itself is very heavy. Now, neither of these have affected me at all. I've been using an IPF approved bar for a while, so it has a smaller little sleeve, so I'm really used to just a straight walkout without hitting the rack. But because it is using a thicker diameter metal, you do have a little bit less clearance for the bar, so if your walkout's sloppy, you're gonna hit the bar. The same with the complaint on the bench spotters is that when they come down, if you're not coming down perfectly straight, you're not in the center of the bench, you might hit those bench spotting arms with the plate. So that's something to think about, although I've never had either of those happen to me, and I've had the combo rack for months. The next one's gonna be the Elite FTS. It's not IPF approved. So it's more expensive than the Rogue Rack, and it's built similarly. I'd say they're pretty close to the same build quality, but I'd have to give it to Rogue a little bit higher. So that's definitely a negative. Why spend more money to get something that isn't approved, right? Next, the ER Rack. It's about the same cost as the Rogue, but the build quality isn't as good. So if you've ever used an ER Rack, I've used one in competition. As soon as you grab it, it's like shaking all over the place. You can grab it and it'll move back and forth. It's not as heavy, so that makes it move back and forth. And you know these things aren't gonna be bolted to the ground because they're putting out a platform at most meets and throwing the combo rack on top. So, and we already established that the gauge of the steel isn't equal to that of the Elite FTS or the Rogue Rack. The Texas Strength System, one of the biggest cons is that they're said to have very bad customer service. So if you become scratched or it comes with a problem or a nick or you need to contact them for whatever reason, just not me personally, I haven't had a problem with them, but I've just heard that it's very bad. It's also kind of annoying that you have to buy the spotter arm separately and they're not included, and it's not IPF approved. The Alico Rack, you're definitely paying for the name on the Alico Rack. As good as I'm sure the Alico Rack's great. I haven't personally used it. I've seen one. I've had a client that I was coaching at a meet use one before, and it looked like it was good shape and everything, but considering the materials used aren't as expensive, I don't know why it's, nearly $2,000 more than the one right below it, right? And then the Bells of Steel, it's simple. It's made to be cost effective. So if you're just looking for a combo rack just to kind of get the sensation of competition, but you don't have a lot of money, that's the one you would go with. So being made to be cost effective, it's not going to really be able to compete with the other top brands. Oh, and it's not IPF approved. All right, so here we go. Are they IPF approved? Pretty much staggering back and forth. Rogue, yes. Elite FTS, no. ER, yes. Texas Strength System, no. Alico, yes. Bells of Steel, no. Now let's move on to the major one, biggest pros. So the Rogue is made with 3x3 7 gauge steel. There's UHMW plastic everywhere, and it has the biggest pad legal. So it's as long as it can be and it's as wide as it can be. And if you've ever been on a Rogue combo rack and then went to any other combo rack, there's nothing like that Rogue pad. It just sinks in, it's nice and deep, you have way more stability. So that was definitely a big factor for me when picking which one I personally wanted. Next, the Elite FTS rack. It also uses 3x3 steel and 7 gauge steel throughout it. So that's a huge plus, as those are the only two with the 3x3 7 gauge steel. Next is the ER rack. So it's IPF approved, right? That's awesome. But it was IPF approved first before any other combo rack. So anyone that was doing a USAPL meet or an IPF meet in the United States was probably buying this ER rack, so it's the most common. So it's the most likely that you'll have to use this one in competition. So, I mean, if you just always know you're going to be on an ER rack, maybe you would go with this one because you want to train on the equipment you're on, and usually you have better carryover into the meet. Next is the Texas Strength System rack. It is the cheapest rack made with 7 to 11 gauge steel. All right, so the Alico is made with 7 and 11, most likely, because they don't have a spec, and the Bells of Steel is made with 12 gauge steel. So the Texas Strength System, if you just want something that's fairly beefy and it's a good price, like, I'd go with that one, although again, it's not IPF approved. Next is the Alico. It's good quality with a very well-known name, so I doubt you're gonna have a problem. If you do have a problem, I'm sure they'll help you and take care of you. It does kind of suck that they're in Sweden, but they're known to be one of the best when it comes to making equipment. And the pros of the Bells of Steel is pretty much that it's cheap. The build quality isn't gonna be there. It's not gonna have all nice little features and everything, but again, if you just need a combo rack, it's cheap. There's really gonna be no pro that outweighs anything in the Bells of Steel. Besides that, it's cheap. All right, so my top picks in order would be the Rogue. It's the has the best build quality. It's IPF approved, and it comes with Rogue's great service. So if you've ever gotten anything from Rogue, you know, if you ever have a problem, they'll probably just send whatever it is right out to you. They're not gonna charge you shipping. They might even not make this you make you send it back. They're right there. They definitely take care of you, and they do it in a very timely manner. Next is gonna be the Elite FTS rack. It gets second for pretty much one of the big distinctions is that it's not IPF approved, and you're gonna end up paying more money for it, right? So having a higher price point kind of sucks, and Rogues has slightly better build quality. There's definitely more UHMW plastic over the Rogue, and I don't know, there's just something about it. If you see them both in person, you most likely would not be like, yeah, I want the Elite FTS one. Again, coming in at number three is the ER rack. Just like I said earlier, it's the most common rack to see in competition. Train how you play. If that's all that really matters to you, you know you're gonna be on this rack, buy this rack. Why train? If you get used to training on something like the Rogue rack with that nice, big, thick, comfy pad, and then you go on an ER rack, it's probably not gonna help you out at all. You're gonna be so spoiled with the Rogue rack. Then we look at the Alico rack. It's a good rack. It's just not worth the money, in my opinion. So what are you really paying the extra money for? If you just have everything Alico, you're an Alico freak, I guess you could go buy the Alico rack, but why else would you want to invest so much more money into that one than the other three listed above, right? Coming in at number five is the Texas Strength System rack. So it is equal quality, like equal build quality, I'd say, to the ER rack. But it's less common to see in competition, and it's not IPF approved, it doesn't come with a spotter arm, so there's a lot of variables to think about, but I'm giving it number five. Coming in last at number six is gonna be the Bells of Steel rack. If you need a cheap option, this is pretty much what you're gonna go with. I really don't see a reason to get it other than it's cheap. Now, I heard a couple days ago that Titan Fitness released a combo rack, and that's probably gonna have a similar opinion. I haven't really looked at it yet, but I doubt it was something I would ever recommend, especially coming from Titan Fitness. All right. All right, I did wanna tell you the two biggest complaints that I've heard about this rack. And to me, I wouldn't even really consider it a complaint, but it is something that people are complaining about, so I figured I'd tell you regardless. Number one, the bench is pretty heavy, right? Like I said, it has the biggest pad, the longest pad. So getting it out of here can be a little awkward. You just pick it up, walk it back, and then it's out. It's definitely a lot bigger and heavier than any of the other combo racks, but shouldn't that be a positive thing, right? It's overbuilt, so it's heavier, right? The next one, pick this up so you can see, is that the distance between here and here, so when there's plates on here, if you walk out and you're crooked, you're gonna hit the plate against the upright. Again, I've been squatting with this IPF approved bar, so it has a smaller sleeve than say like a Texas Power Bar or a regular Ohio Power Bar. So my walkout's been pretty straight, so I haven't had a problem with it. I was using this squatting out of the rack beforehand. So I have yet to hit the plates on this rack. Now, if you're just used to having a smaller diameter and your walkout's not straight and you hit it, yeah, I can see that can be frustrating, but it should be something that just gets better over time. And worst case scenario is it forces you to walk out straighter, right? And the next one is when the bench is in here, kind of the same complaint, right? For a different thing, is that when the bar comes down, if you have these uprights in your bench pressing, these uprights are for the safeties here, that if you're off, people are complaining about hitting the plate on these safeties. Again, haven't had it happen yet. Had the rack probably a couple months. But I can see how that could be frustrating if it is something you just get this rack right away and it's something you need to change in your technique to be able to even use the rack without banging and crashing into it. All right, just figured I'd let you know. And just for ha-has, I'm gonna check how heavy the bench actually is. So all of you complaining about not being able to get that one, see how weak you are. And it's 118, if you can see that. And in case you do actually get this rack, the two things you need to know when you're putting it together are that the instructions aren't very good about, and I've seen other people do it wrong, is these bushings, these copper looking bushings, right? So we can get it to focus. There you go, right there. Go on the inside to keep this surface from being metal on metal, right? The next one is, there's pins down in here, right here, that you have to take out and remove to slide down in the main upright, okay? To take these out, you do not hit it with a hammer, all right? They're probably gonna be tightened. There's an Allen screw. It'll focus. Well, it's right there, right? You loosen that one, you loosen this one on this side, this pin slides right out, you line up the hole, you put the upright down in there, you slide it back in, you tighten them back up. Do not hit it with a hammer. I repeat, the Rogue instructions do not say anything about installing that. And I already saw one other review that the solution was a hammer. Look at all of this UHMW plastic, ready? Safety, going up the side of the safety, right? It's on the outside of the rack. It's on the upside, goes back in, back up again. Same thing on this side. It's just every surface you could possibly imagine, even the outside right here, it's all covered with that plastic. So that's good safety for the bar. I mean, but it's also like, think about it. If you're not gonna scratch up the rack itself, you're gonna scratch up the plastic. And if you ever wanted to change this 10 years later, you could change it out, right? So I think that's pretty cool. All right, I wanted to point out a couple other things. Rogue does recommend that you bolt this to the ground, right? In those two locations. But most combo racks I see in gyms are not bolted to the ground. And simply because if you want to do a meet, usually you're bringing it, or if you're an affiliate of a federation, you're going to need to bring it places to do the meet, right? But I will say it has the biggest footprint, so I highly doubt this thing is ever going to flip over with any weight. Something else that's pretty cool is these bench spotting arms. Usually these feet on most combo racks don't even make it out that in front of those spotter arms, right? This one goes quite a bit past it. So I'm not saying in a home gym you should squat out of your combo rack, because by the time you walk out, you could be really close and just miss them completely. What I will say is if you land on these with 500, 600, 700 pounds, I don't think they're gonna go anywhere. Now, the other combo racks, yeah, I don't think that if you landed on it, the rack is gonna exactly stay in place. So I hope that helped you guys out. I think it's pretty obvious which one I went with. It was the one that, you know, I recommend it to you guys right before this clip. I don't really know why you would go with any other one unless you are having a problem with your funds. It is definitely the best built one, in my opinion. God forbid I don't put my opinion in there. I know they're all trampled on. But it's the best built one. And it comes in kind of at the middle at price point, right? So I really think when Rode made this rack, they looked at all the other racks and kind of said, hey, what can we improve on that? So the only real negative on the rack, like I said, is there's less gap between here. So if you kind of walk it out a little funky, you're gonna hit the rack, you're gonna be pissed off, but that's more your shitty form than anything. So hope this helps you guys out. If you like the video, maybe give it a share. I don't know. I don't do this enough to remember what I'm supposed to ask you guys to do for me. But pretty much, just leave me a comment down below. Let me know how I did. And peace.